I'm Maddie Lee, coming to you after the Thunder's 120-100 win at Sacramento. Thunder on an impressive road winning streak now. It's at six wins on the road in a row, which is tied for the second best road winning streak in Thunder history. So off to a great start on this two-game road trip with a absolutely dominant win over the Kings. The Thunder started out not shooting very well, but the Kings shot even worse, and the Thunder held them to just 16 points in that first quarter. And then in the second quarter, the Thunder's offense really started going, which was led by Dennis Schroeder, who ended up finishing the game with a team-high 24 points. But just behind him was Lu Dort, who got another start in place of Terrence Ferguson tonight and hit five threes, which only, according to the Fox Sports broadcast, only four rookies, Thunder rookies, have done in history. So putting his name up there with some of the best. And Lu is a guy who is known a lot more for his defense, and that's how he earned these starts. But his offense is really coming along, mostly because he's picking his spots well. Those threes that he's shooting are generally open catch-and-shoot threes, which are great shots for him, even though he started the season not shooting very well. Those tended to be, he was missing on contested threes, which are not great shots for a guy like Lu Dort to have. But if he can keep making good decisions and shooting the way he is on open threes, he's in really good shape with the way that his defense has looked so far this season. So great production from him. The Thunder also got Chris Paul back. This was his first game since the death of Kobe Bryant. He was out the other day on Monday against Dallas for personal reasons, and he posted a really emotional tribute to Kobe on his Instagram with pictures of him and Kobe and also of their kids together, including a picture of Chris's son, Chris Jr., and Gianna, who also died in the helicopter crash. So he was back tonight, and he said that was probably the best thing for him because Kobe wouldn't have had it any other way. Chris did not have a great shooting night tonight, but obviously a very emotional night, and he still contributed with 7 rebounds and 10 assists. So made his contributions where he could. And then the Thunder was blowing the Kings out so much that he didn't have to play late in the game. Really, it started late in the second quarter with three-point shooting was where the Thunder made its mark, and that continued through the third, where they got up by well over 20 points over the Kings and were able to carry that through. The Kings ended up shooting better than the 20-some percent that they were shooting in the first period, but clearly not well enough to compete with the Thunder's very efficient performance. So next, the Thunder heads to Phoenix to play the Suns on Friday, and we'll see you then.